Just slightly over a month, our PMX says that whatever antarabangsa punya news says about reducing the subsidy of fuel is laporan yang tak beretika. Notice his choice of words. He did not say it is untrue. He did not say it's fitnah. He did not deny it. But he merely made a comment, is laporan tak beretika.
Perdana Menteri Dato' Sri Anwar Ibrahim menganggap media antarabangsa yang mendakwa kononnya kerajaan akan mengurangkan subsidi bahan api menjelang bulan hadapan dalam laporan yang sekadar memetik sumber tidak diketahui sebagai tidak beretika. Tegas beliau, setakat ini belum ada sebarang keputusan muktamad diputuskan kerajaan walaupun ada perbincangan awal bersama jemaah menteri.
Jadi saya lihat ini nampak berlarutan. Dan saya harap kita terima prinsip kebebasan, tetapi harus ada etika berdasarkan fakta dan keputusan. Dalam hal ini, jemaah menteri belum membuat apa sebarang keputusan. Utama. Jadi bagaimana boleh kita pastikan sekian-sekian kerana motif-motif yang tidak sihat. Kerana kalau kita nak laksanakan, saya beritahu dia tidak akan membebankan rakyat. Maknanya, seperti minyak elektrik.
Tambahnya, laporan berkenaan juga mirip kepada tuduhan yang mendakwa kerajaan akan mengeluarkan lesen untuk pengoperasian kasino di Forest City Johor sebelum ini. Dato' Sri Anwar ditemui selepas mengadakan pertemuan bersama pemimpin masyarakat di Permatang Pauh Pulau Pinang pagi tadi. Semalam, sebuah akhbar berita asing melaporkan Malaysia bercadang melakukan pemotongan subsidi bahan api sebagai sebahagian langkah reformasi ekonomi. Memetik sumber industri dan kerajaan, akhbar itu mendakwa harga diesel akan diapungkan mengikut harga pasaran. Ia juga mendakwa langkah itu akan disusuli peningkatan berperingkat-peringkat harga runcit petrol.
So now we all know what beretika means. Takkan masa tu dia tak tahu that diesel punya harga nak rationalize. So therefore, tak beretika means is that laporan tu preceded his desire for all of us to know. Why? Because elections was looming. So therefore, tak nak buat. Election dulu, takut election kalah. Takut sangat. Popularity dia appear jatuh. So lepas tu dia kata tak beretika. And dia deny first. Lepas tu, diesel pagar naik. Okay, now in the meanwhile, video dia in the past, yang lama-lama semua, hari ni kita ambil alih kerajaan, esok bagi saya 24 jam, dalam masa 24 jam, minyak, harga minyak turun. Tak berhenti, the videos are playing all the way. So therefore, there has always been Anwar dengan Pakatan Rakyat punya, Pakatan Rakyat punya manifesto to reduce harga minyak. Now, in defense of PM, masa dia kata harga minyak tu nak turun, berapa harga masa tu? What was harga semasa at that point of time? Now, today, apa harga semasa? So, therefore, harga semasa sekarang kau dah tinggi, nak turun macam mana? Because daripada dulu tu tak naik dah masa tu, kan? So, therefore, mungkin tak boleh and mungkin country suffer. Tapi the point is, SPM, my advice to PMX, because obviously yang ni I kena advice lah. Dia tak reti dah, credibility dia. You kena reconcile. You got to clarify to the people. How, why, what make you decide to say harga minyak turun masa tu? Kena explain. You get lah Raja Formula Rafizi ke, Fahmi Fadil ke, explain. Masa tu, harga minyak semasa was X price. Harga yang jual di kios, Y price. Beza banyak. Jadi kita nak turun margin dia supaya kurangkan margin kerajaan punya pendapatan or whatever. Now today, harga minyak semasa dah price A dah. And price B tinggi sikit je daripada A. Therefore tak boleh nak kurangkan. Tak boleh dah. Maknanya, whatever the janji is at that time kalau ambil alih kerajaan, turun. Tapi at that time tak ambil alih kerajaan. Jadi orang pula takkan lupa, when was the last time you promised. So bila GE yang baru ni yang yang dia menang ni, Madani Government is formed, Pakatan Rakyat menang paling besar, tapi still Pakatan Harapan menang paling besar tetapi tak cukup, kena marry UMNO. Okay, so tak apalah ada marry UMNO semua, tapi masa tu ada tak janji harga minyak turun? Kalau tak ada, then rakyat tak payah nak pegang ni, faham tak? Dia tak kata, kalau dia tak kata in the recent election ni, that means you elected not because you nak harga minyak turun. You fed up pasal 1MDB and GST semua tu. Kan? So, harga minyak eventually kena rationalize pun. Takkan subsidize forever. Subsidize tu, bila kerajaan subsidize, dia subsidize pakai duit kerajaan. Duit kerajaan je siapa? Duit kita. So, kalau kerajaan punya duit lagi banyak subsidize pada minyak, siapa pakai lagi banyak minyak? Orang kaya ke orang miskin? Jawab soalan tu. Siapa lagi banyak kereta, siapa enjin lagi besar, siapa jalan merata-rata lagi? Jadi kalau orang kaya pakai banyak minyak, jadi subsidi itu kebanyakan pergi pada orang kaya. Jadi kena understand that. Jadi orang yang tak berapa kaya need to understand, kalau subsidi dikurangkan, it simply means that orang kaya lah ni dapat kurang daripada, kurang lagi lah subsidi yang dapat tu. Orang miskin dapat kurang, tapi orang miskin on top of that ada bersasar, dapat balik duit kerajaan. So therefore, you know, overall in the long run lagi elok untuk orang yang tak kaya sangat. Orang kaya now got to pay the real price of oil lah, kan, of minyak. Okay, I'm not super excited about it, but I just have to speak the truth. Okay, now tetapi kerajaan dah cerita dah banyak mana dia boleh, dia boleh stop seludup penyeludupan, dia boleh save sampai 4 bilion. Okay, so now my question is, sebagai rakyat, you save semua banyak-banyak duit ni, pakai duit untuk apa? Untuk ampunkan Najib lagi? Untuk bagi balik? Itu dah bagi 160 juta balik dah. So lepas ni 1MDB, kalau dia kena denda, kalau 2.6 bilion kali 5, that would be 13 bilion tau Najib kena bayar denda on top of whatever jail term yang dia akan kena. So lepas ni tuanku mana pula yang belas kasihan pada hemat hemat beta, belas kasihan patut diberi pada penyakau pencuri negara ni, and apa ni, nak kurangkan banyak mana pula denda tu. So I tak tahu, I don't know what this current king is all about. Could be 2x5, 5x2 dengan the outgoing king dulu tu. So now bila rakyat terbeban kena bayar because you want to save, tapi the savings tu is going back to the kleptokrat yang sakar bagi kita, that becomes a pain in the you know where lah, kan, where the sun doesn't shine. So jadi this is bloody annoying and irritating. And as far as apa ni PMX is concerned, bila orang kata diesel punya harga nak naik ke apakah, oh tak ber, tak beretika, marah orang, cerita. Lepas tu jadi, lepas tu naik. So banyak benda you kata won't happen, then merely months or sekejap je lepas tu jadi. So therefore, you know, you may not bother about credibility lah. You are so worried about popularity, that you are popular, you are rakyat suka you, tapi you tak worried about credibility. Your words now means nothing. You say this, esok cerita lain. Jadi bila orang news report, news reported kata harga diesel akan naik, oh tak beretika. Last kali betul eh? So now at the end, whose credibility is maintained, whose credibility jatuh? Prime Minister tak ada credibility lah, kerajaan tak ada credibility lah, news orang percaya yang tu. Jadi bila news cerita benda yang akan berlaku, betul-betul berlaku despite kerajaan deny, siapa orang percaya? Ketuk kepala tanya, percaya news ke percaya kerajaan? Bila orang percaya external news, then people look at whatever external news buat. Lepas ni external news tembak ke tembera ke, orang percaya. Orang means not just rakyat tau, orang means investor, analyst, dunia. And that will invariably affect kita punya economy kalau orang rely on external news rather than the news that comes from the mainstream, from the government. And semua from government semua nampak macam tipu. The optics is that macam tipu. You say minyak turun tapi minyak naik. Cikgu Bat dengan Papa Gomo cerita, you know, report yang external news kata Agong dengan PM nak approve kasino. Now, I tak kata I oppose or not lah. Mungkin ada orang sokong pasal revenue, ada orang tak suka pasal benda tu haram, kata Islamik. Bila report tu dah kena hold up by police dah, mereka. Fahmi Fazil dah react dah. Oh, kata defamation lah, nak saman lah, nak take action lah, apa semua tu. Nah, apa beza dia? Tengok-tengok, what fall we know, casino lepas ni approve. Then apa pula, what is the circumstances that change? So notice tak, bila cerita orang kata something will happen, orang tu kena for something yang dia kata tu, and then it happens, senyap. Tak ada explanation to close that gap, to reconcile. Macam mana dulu kata marah orang kata tu, tapi belas kali betul-betul jadi. Then apa yang you bising tu? Takkan hot wash, just nak eye wash kita semua ke? So everything lah. Lepas ni dia kata petrol pula akan naik pula in November. So sekarang ni you tak ada explanation apa pun. And apa ni, keluar news. So lepas ni news pasal petrol pula pun tak beretika lah kot kan? Ke? Betul ke PMX? Tak beretika because now they announce before you want them to announce. Because you still want rakyat punya support and rather assurance that petrol will remain the same. Lepas dia dah bagi kepercayaan, that's when you boleh naik petrol. Because that's how the optics look. It may not be. Kalau you tak supply the narrative, you tak explain kat rakyat, you tak explain pada orang, what change from the time you promise and sekarang you buat the opposite, you tak explain apa beza clearly, there is no forgiveness. Maknanya itu khianat. People will make their own narrative. People will write their own narrative. And people, that narrative is not favorable to the government and to you, Mr. PM. Faham tak? People takkan setuju yang you doing the best for the country. So, jadi you tak boleh, pull a wool over everybody's eye and say, yeah, I fooled you. You dah kena main. So, when voters kata bila kena main, you should know what will happen in the next election. You tak boleh buat, you repair macam mana pun, this will be played up, especially by the opposition. Lah ni, motor punya plate number pun dah tulis, PM, Cibai, tulis macam tu semua. So bila dah keluar macam tu, people dah benci dah. Dulu ada buat tagline, I love PM, semua tu. Masa Najib datang, lepas tu orang dah hate PM. Tapi tak ada orang panggil macam Cibai semua. Tak ada orang kutuk, orang curse. Yang cursing the PMX sekarang ni, the money government, are the Madani supporters themselves. Bukannya yang bukan. Yang PM supporters are laughing at the Madani supporters. Nampak tak? This is really bad because people feel betrayed. You tak explain and at the end of the day, you nak deny. To me, this is not the way to run the country. I'm very shocked that kita punya PMX dengan Madani government dan minister semua, they don't care about credibility of what they say. They say something and it doesn't happen, the opposite happen the next day, dia buat and they're not even responsible enough to explain macam mana jadi macam tu. Macam mana diesel boleh naik sampai RM1.10 mendadak. You do that, you boleh naik sampai 100 ni. And until now you don't explain kenapa Sabah Sarawak tak naik. Kenapa some parts ada rendah lagi harga minyak tinggi? Apa justification dia? You nak jimat 4 bilion. Ya? Kalau kat Sabah Sarawak pun naik, apa salahnya? Kalau you kata Sabah Sarawak susah, duduk jalan kecil je, then bagilah sasaran punya subsidi. Bukankah you kata you nak bagi subsidi bersasar? So, kenapa tak boleh sasarkan untuk Sabah dan Sarawak? Sasarlah pada orang yang perlukan. Orang yang kaya kat Sarawak dan Sabah, kenapa dia kena enjoy subsidi juga when orang kat sini tak boleh? Nah, itu pun tak explain. So therefore, you tak adil and you kata, it's going to be on merit, kena consider affirmative action lah apa semua, tapi tak consistent affirmative action ni pun. Now this is very serious. Kalau you tak peduli, if you look at just being in power for one term, then tak apalah. Kan? I pun tak mau defend dah bila orang panggil Madanon. Okay? Tapi kalau you want to be re-elected, you want to do what's best, I am still supporter of the Madani government, tapi it's waning very fast. Orang dah mula menyampah, orang dah mula nak tukar government dah. Because government depa rasa dah betray dan menipu. Orang gelak sekarang ni. So tak tahulah whether this will be received well by the powers that be, tapi I know for a fact that it will resonate with rakyat. Kalau rakyat resonate, this will go around and people will want this to be heard by the powers that be, supaya bila berlaku esok ni, bila when you get stripped off the power, after see people like Anwar Ibrahim for decades tried to become PM, tried to become government, masuk keluar penjara, went through thick and thin, did everything to try to change, and now he become PM finally. Kings pun suka dia, support dia. So satu term saja kah? Okay kah? You know how pathetic and laughable it will be? But decade-decade to try to be PM, last kali jadi PM 5 term saja. This would be damn shameful. You know, and to me, untuk apalah? I don't understand. So to me, I tengok the way apa ni, the way the country is being run, I tengok memang pelik lah. Teruk sangat. Dengan Grab driver pekak kena pukul, polis cover up, you know, polis punya nama pun jadi busuk, and apa ni, you know, semua senyap menyepi, PM dengan Home Minister, dengan Chief Police semua. To me, what's happening? The investigation, what's happening? Isu Teo Beng Hock, apa cerita? Why tak buka balik? Kenapa? Semua lupa. So, jadi orang remember is all these things. You may think it's small. All these small things put together, when the time comes, it will be played up balik. Come elections, they will vote anything but Madani government. They may even vote a government that they will regret later. Tapi janji bukan Madani government. Nak, takkan nak kena ajak politician benda ni kot. Kalau tak reti lagi, then don't be politician. Don't be government. Kalau reti, maybe terlupa, I tolong peringat. Run the country properly, please. And be forthright and truthful to the rakyat. Jangan hoodwink the rakyat. Assalamualaikum.
If you want to see more content like this, make sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss any new videos.